guys, welcome to the Shy Apple Part 2. You're going to find out today why it's called the Shy Apple. There's one more part to this unit that we're going to do, but let's talk about Part 2 right now. I want you to find an object around the house, and you'll see how the things I've been asking you to do are going to build up on one another to help make your final work better, hopefully, if you've been doing everything I've been asking you to do. I grabbed this hammer because I already know what the project is. Like, pick something that's kind of like loaded with meaning. Like, a hammer has a lot of power. Obviously, you could smash stuff with it. You could tap things in. You could build a house with this. I think these kind of things that, you know, they have like a intrinsic meaning to them. You know what I mean? Like, a fork would be one that I think would have a lot of power to it. Could be whatever you do, but choose wisely. Okay, you're going to be doing quite a bit of drawing around just this object. Okay, so take your time, find it. You should have plenty of time to get it done. This is going to be about 2 hours worth of work altogether. There's no video to watch, there's no list of questions to answer or anything like that. It's just drawing. All right, so it's 9 thumbnails, about 5 minutes each, and one finish. So that's, I'd say that the thumbnails would take, you know, like I said, 5. So that's about an hour for all of those. And then I want you to spend about an hour on the finish. Okay. So I'm going to ask you to draw a minimum of 9 situations or feelings from the list that I'm sending you. Okay. I'll show you what it looks like in a little bit, but, so you know what thumbnailing is. It's just quick, you know, like I said, 5 minutes each on these drawings. And don't go too far into it. You'll have a chance to, you know, widen your possibilities by doing the thumbs. I would do all of them, honestly. But I'm only asking you to do 9. Choose your favorite one, the one that is the most successful, and then I want you to do a finish of it. Okay, so let's look at how this is done. This is going to be not too long of a video, so I'll show you a couple examples and then you're off to it. All right, find some paper. You need a ruler, a nice pencil and eraser. I'd use a pen on my finish. If it was me, I'd say, like, you have to go at least pen to me, like a pencil drawing. It seems preparatory. It's not like a completed drawing. Pen. Ink, paint, these kind of things are more permanent and seem more, a higher level up, okay? So anyway, pencil's fine, though, if that's all you have. All right, guys, remember this. These were the symbols that I asked you to draw, you did last time. You might as well say hi to my little friend here. Look in the camera. Can you see her? She's a pain. She's always wanting to be around and getting into everything. One of the benefits of being at home, and maybe one of the hard things about being at home. Anyway, you know, you should have done this. This is all the symbols. Like, taking observational drawing that we did with the one-to-one drawing, and abstraction, and symbolization, and simplification. And we're gonna put these things together on this exercise. Like, I don't know what you'll do, and your object's gonna vary, but like, I wouldn't draw when I say, like, love, and like, arms and legs on the hammer, making it into a person, unless that's what you know, if you do that, that's not necessarily what I'm asking you to do, okay? So don't automatically go to that. I like you to take the object and, you know, use your imagination. This is a creative exercise. This is a mind-stretching exercise. So start going through these, find some that you like, and start drawing them, okay? So please don't chew that up. Talking to the dog. Here we go. I have some here on this sheet. I think, almost every single one on the list. These ones are okay. I like the next sheet better. This was good. So I'm taking the claustrophobia. I could just barely see the head of the hammer inside the toolbox. He's locked in the toolbox. This one I really thought was funny. This was freedom. This was my interpretation of freedom. So these are the tools on the porch at the retirement home. the pliers. He's dreaming about. They're telling stories to each other about the old days. The screwdriver's like, oh, I used to twist so many nuts and bolts back in the old days. It was despair. I mean, some of these are gonna kind of be simpler. Here's a despair. He's like in a back alley or something, just like sitting on the ground. He's all sad. And the revenge one, I did a role reversal. So this time the hammer is getting nailed. So having another character in is okay. I really like this one too. Dreamer, and he's dreaming about being a hammerhead shark, and he's floating around, he's swimming around in the ocean with the hammerheads, you know, being with his family out in the ocean. I thought that was a good one for Dreamer. The playful answer I gave here, I thought this was cool. I just have a little bit of the hammer coming out of the frame, and then the board, it's nailed the words, I quit. And he's walking away. He's going to go, you know, pursue his dream of being a musician or something like that. So I did a lot of these. I'm only asking you to do 9 and not spending too much time. This one was like longing, or I don't know what it was on the list, but he's like broken up with his girlfriend. She's over here on a table like with another guy, and he's drowning his sorrow in a drink at the bar. I thought that one was pretty good, so I did another rendition. This was multitasking. He was inside a Swiss Army knife. So you see what I'm asking you to do with these thumbnails. I tried to see what it would look like. This one was really pretty good. I was like, this would be what I would call a finish. Okay, it's really drawn pretty tightly. I might go over this with ink if this was what I was going to do, or paint it. I do a painting based on this, or watercolor, color pencils, or something like this. If this was going to be, like, we're in the vein of, she is chewing out the papers. We're in the vein of applied art or commercial art illustration, so this might go into a magazine article or an article on the internet on a web page or something like this. It's conceptual illustration. It's like it carries a concept. This one carries a concept of, maybe the breakup the sadness associated with a breakup or something like that, or longing for the old days, or like, you know, dealing with depression the wrong way, and whatever you're doing. But it catches the attention. This is the one I like the best for some reason. It just made me laugh. And it's about, you know, turning the tables or getting revenge, and the you can just see the top of the hammer here getting nailed in just the way a nail would, and instead of, you know, it's a switch, you know, it's like, this might apply to you if you ever get back at somebody for doing you wrong, you know, this might apply. I don't know, so this would be okay for you to turn in like this, like a really nice pencil drawing, or go over it with pen, or paint it. I did mine on the computer, and this was my finish, and I really, you know, like, it's showing the build. Like, you'll never get to, and like, this isn't the greatest, but you'll never get to something really good if you don't do all that legwork. If I was to say, okay, draw a situation where a hammer and a nail are doing something, and I just sat down to make the painting, there's no way it would have been as good as even as good as this, such as it is, if I wouldn't have done all that preliminary steps, okay? And it's not a lot of time. But in the finish, I showed the nail who hasn't been nailed very well in the plank, and he's dreaming, like, man, if only I was the hammer, I'd show him, you know. I think this is a success, and I don't mind saying so myself. So get to work. I need 2 things from you: the sheet with all your thumbnails, and I luckily have nice paper. I used to. The dog got it. Look. Like I said, it's true when they say the dog ate the homework. I need this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We need one more than this. They could be smaller on a regular piece of paper. 9. And then from your 9, choose 1 and give me a nice pencil finish. All right. I think this was a tighter drawing. Okay. Give me something like this. I'll really be impressed. All right. Do your best. Give it the time it deserves. All right, and then I want to see what you do, and we'll move on to the next stage.